taking into account the school context and student needs. Schools are to release space to varying degrees for the provision of diversified options to cater for students' diverse learning and development needs. How should students make the most of the released space? They could consider studying the extended part of senior secondary mathematics or taking an additional elective subject, including applied learning. They may also engage in more in-depth study of subjects, participate more actively in other learning experiences, as well as life-wide learning activities, and engage in other personal pursuits. Capitalizing on the more diversified learning experiences, students can broaden their knowledge, develop multiple skills, and cultivate positive values and attitudes. Under the optimizing measures, the EDB strongly advises schools to schedule lessons of M1 and M2 of the extended parts of senior secondary mathematics within the regular school timetable. Such arrangement is conducive to students' learning of mathematics and their whole person development. Starting from 2024, the 8 University Grants Committee-funded universities will regard M1 and M2 of the extended parts as an elective subject in the entrance requirements under JUPAS. In other words, Secondary 4 students taking M1 or M2 this school year, that is the 2021-22 school year, can benefit from the new arrangement and have greater flexibility in program selection under JUPAS. Besides, M1 and M2 can better prepare students for university programs, which demand more advanced mathematical knowledge and skills, such as engineering, science, and business. For certain university programs, M1 and M2 are given higher weighting in the calculation of admission scores, or preference is given to students taking M1 or M2. As set out in the Chief Executive's 2021 policy address, we will continue to promote applied learning as a valued senior secondary elective subject by developing more diversified and up-to-date courses, as well as placing equal emphasis on practice and theory to cater for the diverse interests of students and facilitates the exploration of multiple pathways for further studies and career pursuits. Applied learning develops students' knowledge, generic skills, positive values and attitudes in simulated or authentic context. It also deepens students' understanding of vocational and professional education and training, preparing them for further studies and work in future. Applied learning complements other senior secondary subjects to form flexible subject combinations and helps enrich students' subject choices. Applied learning courses are recognized as elective subjects or considered for award of bonus or additional information, varying by individual institutions, faculties, or programs. Each applied learning course generally spans 2 school years at the senior secondary level. Students can start the course as Secondary 4 and complete it as Secondary 5. The results will be released in one go, with those of other HKDSE examination subjects after the completion of the HKDSE examination as Secondary 6. Alternatively, students can start the course as Secondary 5 and complete it as Secondary 6. It is up to schools to decide what applied learning courses to offer and at which year levels to offer. Applied learning courses are diversified, covering 6 areas of studies, namely creative studies, media and communication, business management and law, services, Applied Science, and Engineering and Production. In addition, there are courses covering cross areas of studies, including Applied Learning Vocational English and Applied Learning Chinese for non-Chinese speaking students, the latter of which is provided exclusively for non-Chinese speaking students meeting specified circumstances. Regarding the 2022-24 cohort, that is, the cohort of students sitting the 2024 HKDSE examination, there are a total of 52 applied learning courses, including 9 newly developed courses. Parents can encourage their children to apply to take a maximum of 2 applied learning courses as elective subjects according to their interests and aspirations. Non-Chinese speaking students meeting specified circumstances can also take 1 applied learning Chinese for non-Chinese speaking students course. As mentioned earlier, one of the directional recommendations of the task force concerns according higher priority to values education to keep abreast of the developments in society and meet students' developmental needs. The EDB attaches great importance to values education so as to foster the development of students' positive values, attitudes, and behaviors. Diligence was added to the priority values and attitudes in 2021 on top of the other 9, namely perseverance, respect for others, responsibility, national identity, commitment, integrity, care for others, law-abidingness, and empathy. Building on the implementation of the optimizing measures, schools will develop their school-based values education curricula and step up efforts in developing students' positive values and attitudes in accordance with the guidelines of the CDC and with due regard to the school vision and mission, the school context, students' needs, societal expectations, and so on. Values education should be promoted through various learning platforms to nurture students' positive values, attitudes, and behaviors within and beyond the classroom. Schools can adopt a multi-pronged and coordinated approach to implementing values education. Besides arranging specific lessons, schools can take forward values education through the learning and teaching of subjects, class teacher periods, moral education periods, as well as life-wide learning activities, such as participation in visits, uniformed groups, and service learning. However, the promotion of values education should not rest solely on schools. We hope that parents will understand and support schools' work on values, education, as well as discipline and guidance, and join forces with schools to nurture students into a quality generation. Parents can refer to the Values Education Curriculum Framework Pilot Version, which sets out the learning expectations for students' attitudes and behaviors in different domains, such as personal, family, community, national and global domains, and hold these expectations at home. In doing so, synergy between parents and schools can be achieved, which provides impetus to foster students' moral development and positive behaviors. On the other hand, the optimizing measures can enhance curriculum flexibility for students to participate more actively in life-wide learning activities. In simple terms, life-wide learning provides an authentic setting for students to gain a variety of experiences which are difficult to acquire through classroom learning. In the process of experiential learning, students can apply the knowledge, skills, values and attitudes developed through reflection, to accomplish tasks and solve problems in new contexts. They can therefore develop lifelong learning capabilities to meet the needs of our ever-changing society. The five essential learning experiences so acquired can also foster their whole person development. Parents can support their children in participating more actively in life-wide learning activities within and beyond the classroom so as to make better use of the released space. Here are some examples. In the context of values education, participating in mainland exchange activities enables students to gain a first-hand understanding of our country and its development. They can learn to appreciate and preserve Chinese culture, as well as develop a sense of national identity. Engaging in physical and aesthetic activities can help students adopt a healthy lifestyle. Besides, engaging students in organizing or participating in community service can develop their respect and care for others and cultivate in them a positive attitude towards life and learning. Study tours allow student learning to extend beyond the classroom. Finally, workplace visits and job shadowing programs help students understand their own aspirations, needs, interests, and abilities. These activities also enable them to learn more about work ethics and keep up to date with the workplace. Parents played a crucial role in fostering students' whole person development. Parents should have a thorough understanding of how the optimization of the four senior secondary core subjects can create space to cater for students' diverse learning and developmental needs, and to foster their whole person development. Besides, parents should maintain regular communication with schools, taking the initiative to express views on and expectations of the planning and content of the school curriculum. Finally, parents should listen to their children and understand their learning progress and needs. Encourage them to select senior secondary elective subjects and participate more actively in co-curricular as well as life-wide learning activities, according to their personal interests, abilities, and aspirations, so as to broaden their learning experiences. To end this presentation, we would like to share with you some more online resources provided by the EDB. You can scan the QR codes with your mobile devices, or click the hyperlinks to watch the related videos or browse the related websites. Thank you.